गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन पेज नंबर 3, एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड मिनरल्स. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल टेक प्लेस थ्रू द रूट्स. सो रूट्स हैव गॉट टू फंक्शंस, फर्स्ट टू फिक्स द प्लांट्स टू द सॉयल एंड सेकेंड वन इज एब्जॉर्ब वाटर एंड मिनरल्स फ्रॉम द सॉयल. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, द रूट सिस्टम ऑफ प्लांट्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ मेन ब्रांच. लेट मी ड्रॉ द मेन ब्रांच लाइक दिस. So for example, if it is a main root from which lateral roots arise, so from here some lateral roots they will get arisen, and further some more roots branching will be there. Now lateral roots bear root here. So very small fine structures, and if you see them in the under the microscope, you will see these structures, like these are root hairs, like elongated ones. Okay, so this is a single root cell, hair cell, you can consider them. These one. So these root hair cells, they are unicellular and they are very delicate and they can be damaged easily. So they are regularly replaced by new cells. So this is our main branch, main root, and these are lateral roots. Now the question arises, how the root absorb the water. So you see, these are roots and here soil is there. Okay, so I will consider it to be as a soil, and in this soil water is there. So basically this is soil once again, or water molecules are there. So water molecules, they get into the plant through these root cells by a process called osmosis. And now let us see what is this osmosis. Students, it is a phenomenon from in which water from higher concentration moves to its lower concentration region. Okay, so you all know that water is present in higher amount in the soil, so it will go inside the root cells. Let us see how. So consider this figure on page number 4 in your book. So here you can see these are small molecules of water. So number of smaller molecules of water, it is higher on this side, and the number of these water molecules, it is less over this side. And what is this side? This considered to be as the soil region, and this side is considered to be as the root cell. Okay, and this root cell, the cells, they are having cell membrane, and in the cell membranes small holes are present. Okay, and through these holes the water can move. The small molecules like water, they can move easily from a region of their higher concentration to a region of their lower concentration. And such a membrane is called semi-permeable membrane or semi-permeable cell membrane, because it is a root cell. Okay, why it is called semi-permeable? Because you can see that water has reached from one side to another side, so it is permeable to water, but it is impermeable to bigger molecules. So that's why the name has been stated as semi-permeable membrane. In this figure you can see water molecule. Now this is that fine root cell which I have already drawn. So the water will enter in the plant system through the root cell like this. And thereafter you can see xylem and phloem. The water will move to the heights. Now You see the direction of my pencil. So it is in the direction of the vertical line of the plant. So first horizontal travel will be there, and thereafter a vertical travel will be there. Okay, like this towards you. Now there is an activity to show the osmosis. Activity 1.2. So here resins have been taken in a water, and after some time we will see the resins, they will get swelled up. On the other hand, grapes, they have been dissolved in a sugar solution. Now you can see the grapes, the size of the grapes have been reduced, indicating that water has come out from inside of the grapes to the outside surrounding. Why? Because outside water was less, but the sugar system was more. But inside, water was present in higher concentration and sugar system was present in lower concentration. So water came out from the inside to the outside. Now students, on page number 6, you can see figure 1.6. The water is moving inside the root hair cells and by the process of osmosis. Now these are the cortex or cortical cells. Now here initially the water concentration was less, so water will move in this, thereafter it will move in this, thereafter it will move in this cortical cell, and finally they will go to the xylem system, and here they will start rising up the plant. Now let us see the difference between osmosis and diffusion. Now you know the definition of osmosis. It is the movement of molecules from a region of their higher concentration to a region of their lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. And diffusion definition is also the same, but here no semi-permeable membrane is there. So let us see. Diffusion is the movement of molecules from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration in absence of semi-permeable membrane. So in this definition you need to mention absence of semi-permeable membrane. So students, this is all for today. Goodbye.